Hello and welcome, folks, to yet another episode of Travel Insights with Visionaries and Veterans. Today we have with us Mr. Hussein Patel, Director of TripJack. Hussein is spearheading the online travel business of the Atlas Group under the brand name TripJack, which has achieved record-breaking growth in the Indian online B2B market. TripJack, one of India's leading B2B travel portals, is constantly evolving and adding value to business by giving its distributors and agents the best technology, the best deals, and a user-friendly platform to transact and achieve financial success. With his commitment to upending conventional thinking and innovatively using all possible resources to drive positive change in the lives of customers and stakeholders, Hussein believes in enabling clients and partners to rise and grow alongside the company. Skilled in teamwork, organizational skills, business development, account management, and business strategy, Hussein carries with him a rich experience of 10 years in the ever-evolving and changing travel and tourism industry. Hussein is credited with and is proud to have created one of the largest B2B networks in India, with more than 20,000 travel agent associates across the country. So welcome, Hussein. It's a pleasure to have you here with us.
Thank you for having me. Thank you. So, appreciate the nice comments that you gave. Thank you.
Not at all. It's always a pleasure to introduce someone like you. So now, 10 years in the industry, and as we all know, this industry is something which changes practically every month. The parameters keep changing. So tell us about your past, your journey in the industry so far, since the time you started.
So, firstly, good afternoon, everyone. I had a very humble and, start when I started off with my own father in his business. While I was 16, I started working the first time in Atlas Travels in the Forex division. And I used to attend college in the morning, and later in the day, I used to go back to the office. And I felt like doing this because I thought I could do something concrete in my spare time. I still remember my first trade in the first week of work, where I'd purchased demand drafts worth 1 million Saudi riyals at a rate of 10.5350. I sold it at 1060 without even knowing what is the ongoing rate. So that trade gave me a lot of confidence, and since then there was no looking back. I continued studying and working for 3 years. I was 16 when I started, so finally I had to go back and finish my higher studies. So I went to the UK, I finished my studies and joined Back Business in 2009. Once I started, I was overseeing the Forex department again, and I started keenly observing how the other businesses are managed. So Atlas is a very well known brand for the Hajj and Umrah segment, and we did a lot of pilgrimage departures. So that year, we started with daily departures to Saudi Arabia. And my job was to see the complete operations as a group leader in Saudi Arabia, of managing the operations, hotel contracting, customer relationships and everything. So I stayed in Saudi Arabia for 6 to 8 months in a year, for 3 years, which continued till 2012. There were times when I used to arrive into Bombay from Jeddah, and the same day I used to go back, because the visa validity was only for 30 days. So I had to do this also. So I've gone through a lot in my entire experience, but the main thing is that during this time, I was working on my dream project of taking our company online. And finally, with a lot of struggle and understanding of tech, and I did not even know how to check a base pair. So I understood everything. And on 12th of May, 2012, the first ticket got booked on our portal. So that was good. I started off acquiring 100 customers on my own. So I had a very small and humble beginning from the grassroots level. I approached the agents myself, understood their what are the problems, what are the requirements. And from the beginning, the goal was to build a product which the customer wanted. And touchwood, my record of sales has been a 99% customer onboarding. The industry has been really kind to me and accepted me really well. So I'm really glad for that.
So Atlas was an existing travel agency, but specializing, like you said, in Hajj and Umrah. But you decided to go bigger and get into the consolidation business.
So Atlas was always in consolidation, but always in offline consolidation. Dad wanted to pursue, to go online. We struggled a bit initially. We scrapped one product and we created another product. We scrapped that because the customers wanted something different. When I went in the market and I saw that this is not what they want. So then we redeveloped everything from scratch and then we went to market. But Atlas was always in the consolidation business.
Are you with a technical background, technology as a background, or are you from a commercial background?
I am totally from a commercial background. I believe businesses make tech and technology people, they are like, you know, they can do whatever we tell them to do. So it's really important that the business side is very clear and the understanding is very clear. But I'm fortunate enough that my brother has a very good tech background, two of my brothers in fact. So both of them are in the business along with me and they help me with the technology while I take care of the business side.
So you built your technology team from scratch and they built the platform for you on which you are now running TripCheck.
That's correct.
And is that an in-house team completely?
Yeah, it's a completely in-house team. So when we started off initially, I did not have hang-ups like, you know, I want to have the best technology in place and then only I will start. Obviously, there were a couple of things which were required, but I feel sometimes it's very important to jump into things and then gradually make corrections on the way. On the day one, if you want to have a Ferrari, it's never going to become one, you know, because the expense that you're going to incur to making that Ferrari and you have no business, that very few people are able to achieve that. So I thought that let's start with a Fiat and we'll make it into a Ferrari. So just last year we scrapped it again. So I believe the tech has to change every 5 years and we rebuilt the entire platform again. And after 8 years of working from 2012 to last year, 2018, and we started working on the project. And in 18 months, we finished the new development of the entire new portal and we brought in TripCheck as a new brand.
And what is the rationale behind the brand name? I mean, how did you and why did you think in terms of a name like TripCheck? Was there any thought process behind it?
So we had the online business called as Atlas Travels Online before we brought in TripCheck, and TripCheck is very young, right? The name itself, it's sounds very energetic, and we've been in the B2B business all throughout. It did not really matter, to be honest, to have changed the name as such, but we wanted to do a fresh branding because we are planning to go into other markets outside India. So we wanted to have a catchy phrase and the entire tech was also getting changed. That's why we brought in the new name.
And what are the products which you offer through the TripCheck platform?
So currently we are very heavy on flights business. We are very good in the hotel segment and there are a couple of products to be added now. In the lockdown period, we've been working a lot on adding new products and new features. You'll see that very soon, you'll see a couple of products getting added very shortly.
So when you say couple of products, is it tourism related or is it just going to be hotel bookings or how is it?
So a lot to do with the tourism related segment, transfers, sightseeing, insurance, visas as a product to be brought online. So basically the Umrah packages also is something which we are planning to bring online to our platform. So a lot of things are going to come up very shortly.
That's great to hear. And now, you are a pure B2B player or do you also do B2C?
We do 100% B2B.
You're completely B2B.
Yes.
So, 100%. I mean, being around for 10 years, having started with the technology platform, but of course having a history of doing offline business as well. What are the changes that you have seen in the travel industry? How has it evolved over the last few years? And what are the changes in the trends and the consumer behavior that you have noticed?
So I tell you honestly, the travel industry on the whole has been changing very rapidly every year. And there is a need to constantly evolve and adapt to build a new sustainable business model, I feel. In our case, we feel that these changes are helping us grow because wherever there is a complexity, an opportunity is also created. And we have been able to successfully ride on these opportunities. Also, you know, I think there's always an uncertainty about the future. But what is required is the right implementation and information. And if made available at the right time, the fear of uncertainty will very quickly become an opportunity. That's where my core mantra is, that take as many tasks as possible, bring in complexities into the tool and solve them in a better way than others. And consumer demands, I feel, are also changing very drastically. and very well aware of the things that they want on the trip. So that means the travel agents who are servicing such customers, they need to be more aware to create an impact on the customer confidence. So we regularly organize trade meets, based on webinars, training sessions, talks, trade fairs, where we meet, engage, and engage with agents, help them with their learning. So helping travel agents gain more knowledge about destinations, hotels, sightseeing, etc., which is really helpful and important also going forward.
And have you seen changes in the demands and the requirements of the agents themselves? Have they been coming up to you with some changes which they may require, or some kind of additional tools which they may require on your platform?
Yeah, absolutely. So during the lockdown, we took a lot of feedback from our customers and we asked them what is it that they want to be made better into our platform. So everyone said that our flights product is the best, hotels prices are also pretty good. And everyone's request was that why don't you bring in more content onto the platform and create more products onto the platform, because they've seen the difference that the way we cater to them. So while I was entering business also, even that time the market was pretty saturated. There were many people who were doing online businesses and people told me that why do you want to do this? It's so competitive. But we never stopped. We still achieved what we had to do. So there's always a different way of doing things. The same thing can be done in a different manner. So maybe the customers feel that we can, and hopefully we will be able to add better, same products probably, but in a better fashion. So majorly customers are asking for products from us.
So the demand from the travel agents is basically more products which can be available on the same platform.
Absolutely, yes. So insurance, for example, we don't have, but going forward now and after COVID, it's going to be very important. Everyone is going to want to have travel insurance. So Emirates, for example, they also announced that Dubai would be requiring this, or a self-declaration that if there is anything wrong happens, so you will be responsible for your own expenses. So obviously in such a case, people would not mind spending 500,000 rupees extra and taking an insurance product. So I think there will be a lot of requirement coming in the future of insurance.
And coming from the tech space, do you think the travel industry and the travel agents have really opened up to the benefits of travel technology, or are they still using it only as a tool to book flights and book hotels, or have they understood the ability of technology, how they can be enabled by technology?
I feel everyone has to get enabled with technology in the travel space. So today, all of our processes are automated 100%. And I see value in that completely. So people look upon technology as a cost, but I feel it's an investment. And that investment is only going to reap them a lot of benefits in time, because it helps you to build customer relationships better. Like for example, a normal CRM. How many travel agents today have a CRM? How many of y'all know that what is the date of birth of my client and what is the last time that he traveled? For example, if somebody comes to your office and says that, why don't you recommend a trip to me for the next time I want to travel for 5 days. So you should have a complete graph of the last trips that he has taken. You should see that what are his likes and dislikes, what kind of star category of hotel does he operate, does he choose to stay in, what is the kind of transfer that he want, does he prefer sightseeing before handbooked, or does he prefer it to be booked. So when you talk to a customer and exactly you know what his likes and dislikes are and give him that solution, then your time is also saved. His preference, exactly, he's completely satisfied. So technology in many ways can do a lot of wonders to us, which we don't realize today because we've not invested in that as of now. A lot of automation can happen. Your rebooking can happen automatically. Your billing can happen automatically. Your customers can get a mobile app. They can see their entire journey, what is next, and this is my voucher. A lot of things can be simplified. And I think these are important things, because if we are going to want to survive, which I'm very confident of in the B2B business, we have to have these technologies to differentiate ourselves with the offerings that B2C players are able to give. So it's really important, and I think it is still very underutilized in the B2B space, and a lot of people, I encourage them, don't get demotivated with the this scenario right now that we are going through. Things will go back to normal and we'll be able to bounce back faster.
So you did mention that it is underutilized. The general feel one gets from travel agencies at times that the product which is available has too much or asks for too much, whereas we only want this much. So are you at least training them and educating your agents that, no, this is the way forward and this is the way to go?
So I feel that travel agents already know exactly, you know, they are predefined in their minds that in Dubai, I want to sell this hotel. In Singapore, I want to sell this hotel. They are not exploring too much. They're very sticking to those options only that they prefer. So I feel what we have done, at least on our platform, is that we have a category of preferred hotels in every area. That this is the hotel if you're going for leisure. For example, if somebody searches for one adult on my portal on TripJack, the hotel images, we understand that if there is a one adult traveling, it's mostly going to be a business travel. So he does not want to see an image of a swimming pool. He does not want to see something which does not even matter to him. He wants to see, fine, there is a gym, there's good breakfast, the rooms are neat and clean. So, and if suppose somebody searches for two adults or with two children, so now we show them a swimming pool picture, we show them a garden, we show them obviously the breakfast area and the large space that they have, the results change automatically. So we are pushing agents to make them see what we feel is right, and obviously they have an option to also select whatever is predefined in their minds. So that change we are trying to bring into the platform now. So maybe it will help, let's see.
So how are you doing this? Are you using some kind of AI technology or something of that kind, which works based on, like you said, the profile of the customer just by saying one person or couple with two children? So are you using some kind of technology?
Yeah, we study a lot of data. That what kind of booking is been done by a particular travel agency through our platform. So we see that bookings done mostly are for leisure destinations, if bookings are done for single passengers or business traveler. So accordingly, the results are changed. And suppose on TripJack, if you're not using a particular feature, so we automatically hide that feature and we show you the features that you usually use. You have the option to access that feature, but it's just that we hide it somehow so that you have a very clear customer experience. And at the same time, you know, we also make recommendations seamless to you based on your previous booking data.
So now coming to the current situation, the COVID-19, which has come and hit the travel industry really, really badly and brought us to our knees. But of course, we all know that, you know, the revival is around the corner, hopefully. Do you think in this scenario, technology will play even a greater role?
So I personally feel that, you know, trust is the new currency of travel. I feel travel agents will play an extremely crucial role in bringing the industry back to pre-COVID levels. Travelers have had a very bitter experience managing their bookings onto B2C websites, connecting to the call centers, having difficulties in long waits and still getting unsatisfactory response, right? On the other hand, our travel partners have proactively answered all the calls, answered, you know, all the customers, given them promises and adhered to those promises, gotten the refunds, or at least have, you know, told them that we are fighting for your refund. Because we all understand today what is the meaning of getting a refund from an airline, hotel, supplier, whatever. So the hard work that travel agencies have put in are not going to go for waste. So it's a pure difference, I feel, between standardization versus personalization. So a right mix of both is very crucial. And that would be the breakthrough for this industry if you are able to achieve that after this COVID is over. So personally, I would like to see that travel agents should adopt to technology, should adopt to various methods of automating their tools. And customers today are really smart. They can see the difference. If there is, for example, an option being given by an agent who's also having a B2C website, you would prefer to do transaction on his B2C platform and at the same time take his services offline on a phone. Because even if you're traveling abroad, you can just send a WhatsApp message to your agent and ask him that I want to stay for two more days. So can you extend my trip? He'd happily do it because as it is, you are servicing him offline. So now the customer has an option to book online, get the same offers that he gets from all other B2C partners, and we want to facilitate that. So there is a plan. We will come back with that hopefully in a couple of months, and that should help personally, I feel.
And do you think the COVID-19 will change the way people travel, in a sense the ultimate customer, and also how the agents will sell experiences and services to their customers?
Absolutely. COVID has changed everything. For the way as we travel as individuals, contactless check-ins, restricted access at the certain zones at the airport, masks, headgears to be worn all the time on the flight. Just completely stole the experience of traveling, you know. The fun of travel is gone because of this. So experience has definitely changed. But one silver lining I feel is that if there is any travel going to happen right now during this period, I feel every booking will happen in advance. There were customers who would reach the destination and then would plan their transfer. They would probably just do a booking for one night at a hotel and then go and see somewhere, place where they feel is more comfortable or cheaper. I think that's gone. Everyone is going to pre-plan their trip. They are going to want to know that what is the transfer that you're going to give me. People are not taking Ola and Uber in India also right now. There are a lot of people for airport transfers, they're preferring to take private vehicles. They are taking, daily rental vehicles also now. So this is going to bring a lot of change in the way people travel. Will give a lot of opportunity for travel agents to sell these services, which they were not buying earlier. And once they start buying, they will continue with that trend. Because we all understand, pre-booking definitely saves money. So we are not only helping them book, we are helping them book at a lesser cost and giving them the service that they need. So everything I feel is going to change.
So on your technology platform, will you now be giving more information to your agents in terms of local happenings, local rules, local requirements? Are you building all that into your platform?
So on our platform, yes, of course we are. Some things what we are doing is that we have a lot of information from hotel providers now who are going to give us information about the sanitization methods that they are following, which we will be showing on the search result page of the hotel listing. Personally, I feel larger brands across the budget, mid-range and luxury range will take a lot of advantage of this, and because the trust factor will be higher on brands. And everyone's going to throw a deal now. So if you never thought of traveling into, let's say, Accor Group or Oberoi Group, now you would want to because they are giving those prices and they are coming up with those levels that of sanitization. So we are definitely doing that.
And what about things like quarantine rules? You did mention about declaration forms, etc. Are you providing all these details to the agents online so that they can pass it on to the ultimate customer?
So we have created a page where customers can access on whatever information that we get from all the airlines. To be honest, the policies are changing so rapidly that today if I send you something, maybe 2 days later, something else would come up. So there's a lot of confusion with airlines itself. Hotel providers are also selling something else. So we are trying to give as much as and every information possible, but the policies keep on changing a lot, I would say that.
And what about visa information? Are you also assisting the agents in terms of at least visa information, if not documentation, etc.?
So we have a team. We have a team of 30 people, in fact, who manage the entire B2B visa business for us. So a lot of consulates who are based in Mumbai and all our travel partners in, for example, Gujarat, Maharashtra, Karnataka, they all have to submit their passports into Mumbai. So we facilitate that business completely. They have a 35 people team to manage the entire visa business.
We do have. But is the information available online on the portal for the?
Yeah, absolutely. There is a platform where people can log in. They can download all the requirements, the forms. In fact, there is an option to fill the forms and digitally take a printout of that form. Everything is available online.
So now coming to tourism by itself, you say you're getting into tourism products. How are you positioning yourself there? Are you looking at it as a niche product which you will be selling to your customers, your agents, or are you looking at a generalized kind of thing?
Totally general, because I have got 25,000 travel agents in India and not everyone will sell the same product. So like I said, I have all the products available on the platform, but I choose to sell the product which my system thinks is right for you. So if you are booking a leisure trip, my system would recommend a leisure hotel bill. If you are a business store, so we study the entire data and we give you what we feel is right for you with an option to obviously see everything else.
Now, coming to the platform and your agents, what have you heard from your agents in terms of using your platform? How happy are they? And how much do you listen to them every time they come up if there is an issue, if there is a problem? Do you have a customer service cell?
Yeah, of course. We have a 24/7 customer support department right from the start, actually. From the last 8 years, we've been doing that. And people are quite happy with our platform because what I generally try and do is that I give all the options onto the portal itself. I don't, who does not like to talk to their customers, but I prefer to enable the customer completely onto the platform himself. Because if, let's say, a travel agency gets a call and says, his customer says that I want to change my flight from today to day after tomorrow, he usually would earlier times write an amendment and send us the entire thing, and then after 20 minutes someone would call him, tell him that so and so is the price, and then he would call his customer, probably the price has changed. There are so many things involved in that, right? So we believe in automation. We are coming up with now refundable products, so rescheduling can be done online onto our platform. All the ancillary services, pre-booking, even post-booking, you can add it onto the platform. If you want to add, let's say, a meal or a bag or a seat, even after you book it. So you can come onto TripJack and you can book it. So these things are not available right now in a very nice manner in other portals. And we have tried to do that and we are continuing to grow on it. We've done it for a couple of airlines because every airline's API is very different. So we go very deep and we study the APIs and we do a lot of stuff at our end to help you enable to sell better and service your customers better.
And coming to your platform for travel agents, how do you price it? Is it like a one-time setup fee or is it on a SaaS model? How does it
work? So to use TripJack, it's completely free. We don't charge anything for a sign up. You can sign up and you can start using, and you can do a pay-as-you-go model. You can choose all the payment options, credit card, all the wallets, net banking facilities, everything is available. We've got sales representatives in every part of India. So every state in India, we have a sales representative, and most likely he's not going to be very far from you. So we make sure that we reach over there, we do the customer onboarding online as well as we do it physically. So the customers really like that, because if you sign up on TripJack today, automatically you will get a call in a couple of hours. Someone will map you to a sales representative. The sales representative will visit you or in current times meet you online. He'll explain to you, he'll give you comfort. And if there is anything, the call center is obviously there. The sales representative is obviously there. Many customers call me also. I'm also directly in touch with a lot of them. So we are very approachable, I feel, the way we do business. That's what differentiates us than others.
And do you provide a white label solution or is it an API? How does it work?
So we have an API which is extremely robust. A lot of OTAs use it across the world, in fact. And a lot of Indian partners are also using our API. White label is something which we don't have currently, but like I said, we have a plan to create multiple white labels, hopefully in the next 2 to 3 months, I think not later than September, we will hit the market with the best white label product available.
And the solution you offer to your agents is based on mobile, or is it only on a desktop?
No, it is on mobile. It is available on mobile. 12-15% of our bookings happen on mobile. Since we are B2B, usually people don't use it, but still, according to what I know, 10-15% in B2B is pretty high.
And do you give your agents the facility of creating it as a B2C platform for their customers, where there can be a login and the customer can directly go and book on this website, so to speak?
Currently, we don't have that, but in the white label solution, we will be giving that.
That would be. So great, Hussain. I guess you've got everything covered, and TripJack is soon going to be one of the biggest players, probably. We already are very big with 20,000 agents. So it's really great to hear that we have another option in terms of technology empowerment for travel agents. And before we end off, any parting comments from your side for the travel industry as a whole?
I'd like to say that the price of success is hard work, patience and a few sacrifices. Travel agents should not lose focus from the core business and continue to service their customers like they have. We all have spent a lot of years in the trade, and these are testing times. This will pass. And I feel the urge to travel will be the highest point after this pandemic is over. So let's stick to our guns and let's service our customers in the best possible way, and hopefully we will bounce back stronger than ever.
Thank you, Hussain. Thank you so much. That optimism is what all of us require. And thank you for coming on the show today. And we'll catch up with you soon once again.
Brilliant.
And to our viewers, we hope you enjoyed the show today. And please don't forget to click on like, share, and subscribe. And until next time, take care, stay safe, stay healthy.